Let's build a connected sensor. I'll navigate to the connected sensor IoT application where I can find material resources along with a guide to help me generate code. First, I'll set my API credentials so that I can use them with any of Tembu's utility email queries. Next, I'll create an email alert. This will be triggered when our sensor detects a temperature that's higher than our high threshold or lower than our low threshold. I'll store an email token, which can be used to remotely reprogram where the alert is sent through a web app that comes with this application. We'll use the same technique to store a high and low threshold, which can also each be remotely reprogrammed through the web app. Now I'm ready to select my board. I'm going to choose the Samsung Artik 10. Here, I'll find circuit diagrams that indicate how to connect my hardware. Now I'm ready to download the code. If we look at our code, we can see where the input pin is set, where our thresholds are retrieved, and where our conditions are set to trigger the Corio calls. Now let's put it all together and see it in action. I have our board here and it's connected to our sensor, along with an aluminum coating. I've added two LEDs, a yellow one to tell us when we're in the safe zone and a red one to tell us when we're higher than the high threshold or lower than the low threshold. I can set my thresholds dynamically through the web app that came with IoT application code, along with the email address where I'd like the alerts to be sent. I'll go ahead and trigger our sensor by placing it into this hot water. And I've set our high threshold at about 70 degrees, so we should see the red light turn on. And there it is. And I've received the email notification. And that's all there is to it, a smart sensor in minutes. Learn how to build this IoT application and many more at the link on your screen.